Hello, Flat Earth researchers, debaters, and debunkers. We're going to disprove the erroneous claim often made by globe Earth defenders that only on a globe can you see the sun rise directly in the east and then set directly in the west during an equinox from any location on the Earth. They say it's impossible to map the equinox observations of the sun on a flat Earth map. So let's have a look at what we see from any given location. This is suncalc.org, and you can choose any location on the Earth and then set the time and the date to see where the sun would rise and follow it across the sky from that location and see where it will set. So we have our location here as Los Angeles, and it's on the 20th of March 2023 at 6:57 in the morning, and so the sun is rising over here in the east for people in Los Angeles. Just a couple of things. This red wavy line here with a black line through it is just showing the path of a partial solar eclipse that occurs on that day. So we're not really interested in that at the moment. We're just focusing on the heading or the direction that we see the sun rise and set from this location. And you can do this yourself from any location. One thing to point out as well is that we see the sun over here in the east, but if we zoom in, we then see the sun appear just a little bit further. So this projection of the sun's location shrinks as you zoom in. So really, we're more interested in the actual heading, which is indeed, as we see it in reality, off to the east of Los Angeles. So take note of the location anyway, bearing in mind that this is a Mercator projection. So we'll see how that is different, and you know it by, I'm sure by now, that the arrangement of the countries and the continents will appear very different in relation to each other depending on what kind of projection you're looking at. But we'll say that this is a fairly accurate representation of the heading that we see the sun, and we'll place the sun there as we see it. So it's below this southern tip of Greenland here, and almost between that eastern edge of Canada and South America here, and further off to the east you'll see the southern tip of Spain, where it joins the northern part of Africa there. And as we go through the day, we'll see that the sun would come to this point at about 10:30 in the morning, and that's when we would see it cross this path of where we would see the partial solar eclipse. But then we go on and we'll go to solar noon, which is basically directly south. Okay, so the sun is at its zenith for anyone in Los Angeles. Basically, it's solar noon, but it's 1 o'clock by the clocks in Los Angeles. And then it goes off over there to the west and sets at about 7 p.m., 12 hours later, pretty much, in the west, directly west of Los Angeles. So of course that's why it's called the equinox, is because we get an equal amount of sunlight and nighttime. So the day is evenly split between pretty much 12 hours each, and this is when you get this the sun rising directly in the east and setting directly in the west. On other days throughout the seasons, this will change. You'll see from different directions that are not directly in line with east and west, but that's why the equinox is often used, because this is the one time when it kind of appears to be the same for everyone on the Earth. Alright, so we'll take this information where we see the sun rising and setting, and we'll put it onto a more familiar flat Earth map. So first up, let's be really clear, it's actually a mistake to say that this is a flat Earth map. It's nothing of the sort. It's just an azimuthal projection from the North Pole. And so there isn't an ice wall, as may be assumed by many, but it's actually a consequence of having this azimuth point at the North Pole. So anywhere from there outwardly is going to be pointing towards the south. And as far as that goes, this works fine if you want to illustrate where the sun or the moon or the stars and the planets are throughout the year at any given time or in the seasons. This is fine. You can easily create a nice 24-hour clock out of this because it's using the same time zones and the same northern azimuth as is used for the northern hemisphere of the globe. The only difference really is that the distance to the equator has been used for the northern hemisphere, or basically the projection from the North Pole goes as far as the equator, and then for an equal distance from the equator to the South Pole, another azimuth projection is created. So you have two azimuth projections that are put together to give us this globe illustration. But it certainly doesn't mean that the Earth is actually shaped like that, just as this projection doesn't mean that the Earth has an ice wall around it. Okay, so the mistake is that this azimuth point isn't moved to where someone is making an observation. Now, anyone that is a navigator will know that whenever you are navigating, or even if you're lost, you're going to try and work out where you are based on celestial navigation if you need to, and the time of day it is, or the time of night. So then you might use Polaris, but basically your headings or your cardinal directions are going to be local. So your azimuth is always where you are, not in the North Pole or anywhere else that you are not. Your azimuth is where you are. So when using this projection with an azimuth based on the North Pole, and then talking about making an observation from somewhere like Los Angeles, for example, we get this misalignment of the cardinal directions. So the cardinal directions are always local to you, okay? So as these projections, whatever they are, whatever shape they take, are still pointed towards the North Pole, then we have the south going in the opposite direction and west and east perpendicular to that. So if I bring up the screenshot of the SunCalc illustration that shows the sun on the equinox in March, and I put the sun in those same locations with those times that we saw on SunCalc on this particular projection, we can see that the sun at 7 a.m. for people in Los Angeles is nowhere near being aligned with their local east. And the same goes for the evening at 7 p.m. when the sun is setting for them, and it's very far away from their local west. But this is just a consequence of the azimuthal projection still being here at the North Pole. When we are located in Los Angeles, our azimuth should be in Los Angeles. And when we do that, the alignment changes and you get something that is more fitting with reality. So let's take a look at how that works. So on this handy application, we have Azimuthal Map Anywhere. And at the moment, we have our azimuth point, as we saw it just now, at the North Pole. And we can see that the US is down beneath it there. And we have Antarctica appearing to be an ice ring. And we can look at an equidistant version, or we can look at an equal area version as well. So you see that it makes a slightly different projection with both of those. So we'll have a look at both of those, but let's just keep it on equidistant for now. You can turn on and off this graticule, and you can also show this equidistant circle. Let me just turn off that and keep that on. So you can see here that as with your usual so-called flat earth map, you have the azimuth point here in the north, and with the globe it would usually go as far as about here, where we have this circle that's pretty much around the equator, and then you would have that connected to a projection that has its azimuth here on the South Pole, you see. So you can choose wherever you want to have your azimuth. And actually, when you are navigating, this is what you need to do. You put your azimuth on a map where you are actually located. And so this is how you get these two hemispheres. But if you were, for example, in Australia or flying over Australia, then you'd be using maps that are for the particular region that you're flying over, and so that would be your azimuth, okay? The projection of your maps and your navigation, your headings, would be from this particular azimuth point. There's no point referring to an azimuth somewhere else. You have to refer to the azimuth of where you are and your local cardinal directions. Okay, so this is something that, of course, any aviator or navigator will know. They don't start at the North Pole, they start at their own specific location. So that becomes your azimuth. So, of course, the map will change in its apparent projection and the relationship between other countries depending on where you put your azimuth. Okay, so let's go ahead and put our azimuth in, where were we? Los Angeles, okay, somewhere around here. Okay, that's now our azimuth, not the North Pole. So let's get rid of that. And we can see here that we've got Antarctica as a continent. And again, as countries get further away, the land masses become more expanded and stretched out, because we're just talking in terms of degrees, really. So it's not a true representation of how they appear. It's just a projection from this particular point. All right. So what we'll do is then we'll transfer this onto an image where we can overlay the sun at different times in the day. And again, just to show you that there is a difference slightly with the equal distance projection. And so this is the correct way, the way that you would navigate around the Earth, to actually say where you are located and what you should see in what direction from that specific location. Your azimuth is always where you are at any given time. So I've taken a screenshot of that equidistant projection with the azimuth on Los Angeles. You can see across there, but I'll just highlight it with that yellow spot. So you can see that now Antarctica is a continent south of America there, and we've got the North Pole up here and these other land masses off to the east and west. So let's go ahead and put in the cardinal directions. Remember that they're always going to be local, because north is always going to be pointing at the North Pole. So the orientation of east and west will change. And of course, the way you project your map will also affect the change in that orientation as well. So we've got this map with this vertical north-south alignment and east and west, as is usually quite familiar. All right, and so let's put the suns there, and we'll put the times. So from Los Angeles, now when we put it on this kind of projection, we've got the sunrise at 7 a.m. over here, much, much closer to being directly in the east. It was way off in the first one that we looked at. 1 p.m., it's directly south. That's the same. Nothing really changes. And then over here on the left, we've got the sun setting in the west at 7 p.m. So it's a lot closer to the west. Now, this, of course, also is affected by the way that all of this curves around like this. So although these cardinal directions are, you know, perpendicular to each other very locally, as you move away, then, you know, they have to follow this circular line that you see, because that's the way it's been projected. Those lines will help you see what has been a straight line turned into a curved line. It's just done by doing it mathematically in this type of projection. All right, so that was an equidistant projection. Now, if we move on to the other type of projection, which was an equal area projection, here we've got, it's zoomed in a little bit, but there's Los Angeles, as you can see it there. Now, what I've done is I've added a blue line here, so you can see that it's directly down from the North Pole and going down towards the south. Okay, but our azimuth is Los Angeles. Our azimuth is not the North Pole anymore, but of course the lines have been maintained in this kind of projection. But this is our azimuth now. And so let's just put in the cardinal directions. You can see north, south there, and west and east there. And when we put in the suns and the times, you can see now they're pretty much in the same location. We've got the sunrise at 7 a.m. as seen from Los Angeles, pretty much directly in the east now. Remember, it was down below the southern tip of Greenland. It was also in line with Spain and Africa there, and it was in between Canada and South America there. At 1 p.m., it's the same as it was. It's just come across from Argentina there. And in the evening, when it sets at 7 p.m., you can see that if you drew a line up from between Australia and New Zealand, it would arrive here. And then as it carries on around, it's much closer to Japan here. So there we have the sun rising east and west on this kind of projection, which is correctly projected because we are putting our azimuth projection point at the point at where we are actually located. And again, any professional navigator knows this. You navigate from your own azimuth. You don't navigate from an azimuth that's not where you are. You plot your path from wherever you're starting from, and you always assume when you're looking at your maps and navigating on the fly that you have a specific azimuth point, and that's where you base all your headings from. It's as simple as that. And of course, the globe earthers often choose to ignore this and pretend that you cannot project this on a flat earth map. So keep in mind that this isn't a flat earth map, it's just an azimuthal projection. And you can put your azimuth anywhere. In fact, you should whenever you're navigating or doing any kind of calculations like this. All right. So thank you very much. And go and try it yourself. Check out suncalc.org. I'll put links in the description to all of these where you can just try this out for yourself from your location or any other location at any time. And you will find that you can indeed align the sunrise and sunset with the cardinal directions in which we see it in reality. Thank you very much.